Quiz of 2017. This is a quiz all about 2017, or as world history will remember it, the final chapter. This show will test your memory, your knowledge of all things 2017, and my patience. Let's meet the teams. We like to call them the A-team. Sorry, not the A-team, that's A-team. It's David Mitchell and Roisin Conaty. Next up, one's the king of grime, the other's past her prime. It's the pride of Brixton and the mild embarrassment of Canada. It's Catherine Ryan and Big Nasty. Finally, these two are like toddlers at a wedding. They're tired, excited, and they're showing off. It's bound to get annoying. Richard Iowati and Noel Fielding. Well, before we get started, let's talk about how our years have been. How was your 2017, David?
I'd say it was personally adequate and internationally disastrous. So, yeah, genuinely, the world looks like it's more likely to end sooner rather than later. But the thing to remember is that at some point, the sun's going to explode. We've got that. That's happening whatever. So whether humanity makes it until the sun explodes or not, it's irrelevant, really, isn't it? So...
Jimmy, my teammate Big Nasty has noticed that David Mitchell sounds like David Mitchell from TV.
He does, he does that in the program. Swear this is some guest. I swear to God, this is major guest for me. I'm some real fanboy thing right now. I'm sorry.
What's your favorite show of David's? What do you like?
The It Thing.
The It Thing.
I'm sorry, the It.
Stephen King's It.
You're in it as well.
Well, he's definitely in it. He's not in it, though, is he?
I don't.
No, Peep Show. Sorry.
I love how you fuse those two shows. The It Peep.
Peep it.
Roisin, highlight of 2017. What was the best bit for you?
I've been an all right year personally, so.
Well, you had Game Face on Channel 4. Huge at your own sitcom. Big Nasty, presumably a good year for you?
Yeah, give God thanks and praise. I've been turning up still. Media, gang.
Now, I didn't get any of that, so...
Well, Jimmy, I looked at a parent's website for those who are bewildered about the language their children use online to try to understand some of Big Nasty's language. BDL, that's Big Defense League. That's what that is.
Base Defense League. Wow, are you getting there? I respect
that. And then Brentekas, Bentekas.
Benteke.
That's good skills.
Jimmy, every time I do the fat quiz, I get closer to you.
Yeah.
And ultimately, I want to be your podium. That's why I've worn this.
Come and stand here next to this. You've come as the podium.
I've come as your podium.
Okay, so the last year, how was 2017 for you?
It was crazy. There were a lot of cakes. I was in a tent at one point. It's weird, isn't it? I did a cake show. I don't know fuck all about cakes.
Richard, how was your 2017?
I couldn't pick out moments. It was a sludge.
What about the Crystal Maze? That was a huge hit.
Oh, right, yes.
You know you were on that, right?
Crystal Maze? No way! Crystal Maze is the whiteboard man. Man, don't talk rubbish to me, bruv.
It's been redone, and Richard Iwadi's hosting it.
Well, it was a huge hit. It's completely eclipsed the original, as we can tell.
The original Crystal Maze host...
Right Said Fred. It was Right Said Fred,
No, it wasn't Right Said Fred. It was Richard O'Brien. It's no use trying to hide. We can still see you. OK, what about team names? Have you got a team name, David, Roisin?
We would like to be referred to as the Tinsel Sisters.
That feels, Roisin, like a decision you made.
But what's the problem with it?
I like
Tinsels,
it.
Christmassy, sisters. You know, some of us are women.
OK, Big Nasty Catherine, what's your team name?
We're going to light them up. We're Team Pain.
Yeah!
The Tinsel Sisters have only come for a night out.
Yeah. Can I just clarify? Is the team called Team Pain? Or is the team called Pain?
I think the team is called Team Pain. Team
OK, so the team name is Team Pain.
Hashtag yeah. with the pain at the beginning as well.
Team Pain, hashtag with the pain at the beginning as well.
Richard, Noel, what is your team name?
I thought we should be called, because he's in Crystal Maze and I'm on the cake show, we should be called Cakes in the Maze. Like snakes on the plane.
Cakes in the Maze. Cakes in the Maze it is. Right, on with the show. Our first round is all about the year's top stories. Let's remind ourselves what happened. In March, Theresa May formally triggered Article 50, officially beginning the highly complex and technical process of fucking up Brexit. In September, Ryanair cancelled thousands of flights after mismanaging pilots' leave. The cancellations meant thousands of people couldn't get to within an 80-mile bus journey of their final destination. OK, let's get started. Here are some questions. OK, first round. It's all about the news, the big headlines this year. Theresa May's speech at the Tory party conference in October was a real low point in a generally disastrous year for her. Can you remember the three things that went wrong during her speech? Point for each. Yeah. Three things went wrong during Theresa May's speech. Question number two. Immediately after Donald Trump's inauguration, Sean Spicer was caught lying about the size of the crowds. What I want to know is, how did Trump supporter Kellyanne Conway explain away the bullshit? OK, what I'm looking for is a phrase that she coined, and I'll give you a clue. It wasn't fake news. Is she winking, or is one eye just... OK, this is an excellent question here, people. This year, Donald Trump proved his statesmanlike qualities in a high-stakes war of words with Kim Jong-un. Trump called Kim short and fat, and Kim called Trump old. But what other unusual insult did the North Korean leader have for Trump? OK, so here's a picture of Kim Jong-un. Here we go. Time, but I think that's the wrong photo. Might be Michael McIntyre. There he is.
Your laugh is so gassed, you know that? Your laugh is majorly gassed.
It is majorly gassed, Jimmy.
Yeah. Just be careful, because I'm very sensitive.
Oh, Mo Farah sign.
That is definitely not the Mo Farah sign. Famously, it's that, isn't it?
It's still a heart, but you've seen it small.
How is that a heart? It's an M for Mo. How's that
really?
A fucking heart?
He couldn't do an M. He's a human being.
Yeah, Jimmy. Yeah, Jimmy.
You're saying it's like a heart. Not exactly a heart, but like a heart. And you're not giving me the M.
It's so like Christmas.
OK, this year saw Brenda from Bristol become an unexpected celebrity after her reaction to which story?
Sex oh!
Jump up! Whoop,
yeah, 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 yeah. Officers.
Even my heart of stone is worn by the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School. We're performing one of their unconventional school plays here. Take a look.
Bun, bun, bun. You can wear these. We can make it quiet. How dare you? This can't be right. Don't worry, we have a recording. Bong, bong, bong.
I mean, they were adorable. So which news story were they acting out there? OK, you ready for answers? First up, I asked you what three things went wrong for Theresa May. What did you all get?
We know them.
Letter fell down, yeah? And then she coughs too much when she's talking about real stuff, yeah? And then someone gave her a P45.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. What have you got, guys?
We got the chronology correct. Extra points for getting the chronology correct. Maybe we don't care about time.
I was allowed the name Tinsel Sisters, and he said, as long as he's in charge of chronology.
Yeah.
OK, David, what have you got then? What three things?
The prankster, brackets, Simon Brodkin, was the name of the prankster.
Play for the P45.
Yeah. OK. I haven't put a comma in. I can only apologise. Cough. She had a cough, a sore throat, kept sipping. And then the letters falling off.
Correct. Richard, did you get this?
I can't read Richard's writing. It's like a doctor's handwriting.
The sign fell off. That's the top left. Middle top, coughing fit. General inhumanity, that's bottom and middle. And then declared war.
On her own haircut.
OK, well, well, let's take a look.
10 years after Northern Rock, our economy is back on track, and the public sector working together. So, while our opponents flirt with a foreign policy of neutrality and prepare for a run on the ground, such an image of modern Britain in all its diversity, compassion and strength that was shared around the
world. Yeah, I mean, I think the answer is that we can't get anything the fuck right in this country anymore. That the people in charge of the sign behind the Prime Minister while she makes her speech can't get the fucking letters to stay on the fucking wall.
So, Dave, am I right that you're just ruling out poltergeists?
I've looked into this.
Good.
They were not glued. They were on with magnets.
Is that real?
They were magnetized letters. Now, why were they magnetized letters? Why weren't they either glued there or painted there?
Glow
no
gum.
Poltergeist in the world can make paint fall off.
As that letter jumps off, you could hear him going, "I'm not listening to any more of this."
Why the magnetized letters? Did they think they might want to change their slogan at the last minute?
That's literally what it was.
Yes, well, go with that for now. We might want to say making Britain a fucking dump.
It's difficult to know how that could have gone worse, really. That's worse than my worst ever gig. My worst ever gig, someone showed me their ass. It's going really badly. Someone
yeah, sorry
just
about
went.
That.
You were there, actually.
I showed you my ass.
Okay, next question. I asked you what term Kellyanne Conway, a Trump supporter, came up with to explain Sean Spicer's bullshit about the presidential inauguration numbers. What did you think? David, Brosheen?
We put much of the crowd were invisible.
They're ruptured.
Yeah.
Mid-rapture.
perhaps the magnets that were supposed to hold them there. But then we put alternative facts, which we think is the actual answer.
OK, did you get this, Big Nasty Catherine?
Yeah, we think that alternative facts have defined most of the year. It's a very famous bullshit way of saying lies.
And the man put fuck Trump.
Oh, yeah, and then your man put fuck Trump as well.
OK, Richard, no?
Very difficult to say again what Richard's written.
Sometimes it's easier to lie, which is the subtext. We went with subtext. It's new to quizzing. Sometimes it's easier to lie and different truths, both of which are the subtext. So why don't we deepen the quiz and not just keep it on the surface.
And give some bonus points for subtext.
Okay, point, no point.
Oh, come on.
That's Trump's inauguration, and that was Obama's. And he said, yep, Trump's was bigger. So I asked you what unusual term Kim Jong-un used to insult President Donald Trump.
Big what? Nasty knows it.
Big Nasty, what was it?
Done to suck donkey dicky balls up.
Okay, David, Roisin, did you know this?
We did know this.
Yeah.
What was the word?
A dotard.
Richard, what was your answer?
Oh, we put. He all got I thought he genuinely one. Said this, that he's old and brittle. He didn't, though, did he? I'm going to have a satsuma
said,
to celebrate.
He said
well, no points. You get a point. Dotard, yeah.
We're getting no points. No. You know you're going to get a segment of satsuma thrown at you now, right?
That'd be good. Okay.
It has to be said, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Why don't you get a seat on this programme?
Jimmy's like a shark. If he sits down, he'll never get up again.
Yeah, famously, sharks, if they sit down, they'll not get up again.
That's why there are no sharks in Boyzone.
So, yes, so Kim Jong-un called him a dotard, which is a weak-minded old person. Next, I asked you what Brenda from Bristol reacted to on the news. I mean, what have you done there, Big Nasty? What's that?
No, yeah, I'm being real. I'm just happy to write with an electronic pen. I've just been gassed. I've just been gassed. I've got to tell the truth. I've just been so...
You haven't written words with it, have you? You've just done a scribble.
Basically, we think Brenda from Bristol was upset about the snap election.
Oh, I can see election somewhere underneath the scribble.
And then...
okay.
Some other
I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. David, Roisin?
We put election quite neatly.
Richard, no.
She expressed emotion.
Which is...
she expressed emotion.
Well, I mean, it's true, but it's not the answer.
Yes.
What was the emotion about, was the question?
It was about she was... They said there was another election and she went, oh, oh, oi.
OK, let's have a look at Brenda in action.
General election.
You're joking. Not another one? Oh, for God's sake, I can't, honestly, I can't stand this. There's too much politics going on at the moment. Why does she need to do it?
That wasn't a real accent. It's like Eurotrash when they put the voice on after.
What? Not another general election! Bloody hell, we've had about three!
OK, lastly for this round, you saw the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School acting out a news story from the year. What do you think it was?
Big clock, fucking loud.
OK, what did you get? Big Nasty, Catherine?
They are stopping a lot of bell ends this year, and Big Ben is no different. That is the silenced bell until 2021.
OK, David, Roisin?
Silencing of Big Ben. Because of the end of Britain.
So at the end of that round, let's take a look at the scores. OK, I can tell you so far, David and Roisin have 7, Big Nasty and Catherine have 6, Richard and Noel are lucky to have 3. Join us after the break for more of what presidential spokesman Sean Spicer assures us is the most watched TV show in all of history. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. Our next round is all about the music of 2017. Let's remind ourselves, in July, Adele was forced to cancel the last 2 shows of her tour after damaging her vocal cords. Adele was left unable to sing in tune. Fine, I guess, but it's never stopped Madonna. After falling down the stairs, it was revealed Simon Cowell suffered from low blood pressure. I guess when you lack an actual heart to pump it around your body, what do you expect? Right, have some more questions. OK, music questions now. First question, it's overdue. Channel 4 News, where the one and only Jon Snow is reporting on one of the biggest songs of the year. Take it away, John.
Dramatic scenes in court today as the trial continues of a 28-year-old American woman accused of murder. Taking the stand, the defendant refuted her ex-boyfriend's claims that the gun was hers, noting that he laughs when he lies and suggesting that he had committed a perfect crime. Testifying for the prosecution, the woman's ex gave a harrowing account of her erratic behaviour, including keeping a list of names on which his appeared in red, underlined, trusting nobody and claiming that she was unable to come to the phone because she was dead. He also strongly denied any responsibility for the woman's felony, despite her repeated claims that he made her do it.
OK, so I need the artist and the song for you to get the point.
Oh, he's describing a song.
How did you miss that? What did you think he was talking about?
It's like making a murderer. I thought, I've missed this. What's happening? Someone's dead. OK, I've got it anyway, I think.
Yeah. How did you get that? Because, I mean, David's no help on this. It's a music round.
Yeah.
Unless it's about Phil Collins' No Jacket Required, he's out.
It's Phil Collins, but seriously. I never bought No Jacket Required. I didn't approve of the sentiment. Having said that, I'm not wearing a jacket, which makes me a hypocrite.
For our next question, can you tell me what unlikely band received a bunch of flowers and a writing credit for their help with the previous song? Gandalf and the Professor, you got something?
That's a better name. We should have had that.
All right. right. OK, so next up, it's over to Corrupt FM. Who have a question?
Oh, shit! Wait, jeez!
Yes, Jimmy. My bit. We play nothing but garage on Corrupt FM, but if we have to venture into the world of popular music, then guess what? Jay-Z is our man.
And this year, he and Beyonce had twins and announced the baby's names on Instagram.
Snape. Nice. Can your teams remember what they called them?
Can you? You decide.
Think about it.
Over to you back in the studio, Jim, mate. Keep it corrupt.
Respect.
So the question was, can we remember their names? So for me, the answer no would be correct.
Nasty. Are you crying?
Look,
I'm hungry.
Okay.
So you're crying because you're hungry? We've been out here about 20 minutes. What are you doing?
I wish I could cry when I was hungry. Because I think it would really stop restaurants serving slowly.
OK, next question. The music video for the hit song Despacito became the most watched YouTube video ever with 4.4 billion views. Can you tell me what the word Despacito means in English?
Again, the correct answer here from me would be, no, I cannot.
Hola, amigo. Me gustaría la tienda, por favor.
You realise that made as much sense to David that doesn't speak Spanish as everything else you said. And finally, for the music round, all I want to know is, how did DJ Tim Westwood embarrass himself on Snapchat in June?
Oh, this is awful.
If you could laugh a little bit less like Jabba the Hutt, that would be... that would be amazing for everyone. OK, right, let's get to the answers. You all got something?
Yeah.
Roche?
All good in the hood.
Go on, Roche. You got to get your ghetto on, girl. Knuckle him.
I've only got little hands.
Okay, let's go to some answers. OK, so I asked you what song Jon Snow was reporting on. Big Nasty, Catherine.
Well, we just want you to know she's dead. And that is in reference to Taylor Swift. Look what you made me do.
Boom!
What did you put?
Careless Whisper.
What did you put, David, Roisin?
First of all, we've got Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
So we've got that.
That's the name of the song.
So, we just wasn't sure of the song. So it's Sorry I Killed That Man.
OK, so Big Nasty, Catherine, you get the point. The other two, you don't get the point. All right, should we take a look? Let's take a look. But I got smarter, I got harder in the nick of time. Honey, I rose up from the dead, I do it all the time. I've got a list of names and yours is in red underlined. I check it once, then I check it twice. Oh, look what you made me do. Look what you made me do. Look what you just made me do. Look what you just made me do.
You just made me die. You were going and never.
Amazing.
Yeah.
That was some serial skanking.
I know.
That was hamburger. He's coming raving. 100%.
Okay, I asked you secondly, who did Taylor Swift give a writing credit to?
We know.
What did you think, Roisin?
Kanye West, thank you very much.
Oh.
No.
No.
What?
Do you mean to tell me the answer is not Kanye West? I feel like such a fool.
You said Kanye West.
I was not...
so wrong. Right. Big Nasty, Catherine.
This is it, yeah? It's where it said Fred.
Yes.
Yeah? Oh. And I'm too sexy for my top.
Yeah, but you know Right Said Fred doesn't present the Crystal Maze, right?
It does, it's the bald egg guy.
There are more than two bald white people.
There are three.
It's Right Said Fred, the guy who did the Crystal Maze, and William Hague is the third one you have to look out for.
OK, and Richard, did you get this?
We said Right Said Crystal Maze.
There's Crystal Maze, guy. Could the guy in the left?
It's me. I'm the guy.
You're in the picture. You're in the middle.
No, here's the it man.
Is that you in the middle, Richard?
I'm not the it man.
You're the peep man.
No, you're peep show.
Yeah.
He's the it man. He's the peep man.
You're the it man.
I'm in the it man as well. We're the it men.
No, he was in that old school program. The ginger guy who was a heavy metal, he lived in the university.
Who do you think I am? Rick Mayall?
No, you're the guy in the green jumper goes.
What, Nigel Planer?
Yeah.
He's about 90.
So what
cheating.
I'm in the ick fucking show.
Tim,
I'm a good cheater.
Mo Farah-sign.
Imagine that.
It's not a Mo Farah-sign. It's not.
If you look at where my knuckles are.
Famously, that is the Mo Farah sign. I don't want to get into this again, but it isn't. There's loads of things that aren't. That isn't either. Oh, look, two of them. Is that any better?
That's almost an M.
That's a bit like...
That's the Jimmy Carr sign.
Oh, fuck's sake.
It's the Jimmy Carr sign.
If you see Jimmy in the street, give him the laugh.
The Jimmy Carr sign.
Give him a chair, please! He's got rickets. Is that how you get rickets from standing up too long? I don't know.
It's a lack of vitamin C, which isn't going to happen to you because you've been eating fruit every two minutes.
I can't let that stand in. It's not a lack of vitamin C, it's a lack of calcium or vitamin D.
Okay. Which is sunlight, basically.
People out there with rickets drinking orange juice, they're wasting their time. Wait till they get scurvy, then have the orange juice.
Don't wait till you've got it to have an orange juice.
No. It's probably too late.
It's too late,
yeah.
Oh, okay. Enough with the scurvy and rickets chat.
Jimmy, it's 2017. People are going to need to know in the future of Brexit.
He is right.
It's all going to be vitamin deficiency and death.
Where else are they
going to
hear it,
Jimmy?
And
this is the last Christmas with turkey. Next year it's rat meat. People will be, you know, breaking into the zoos. Eating the zebras. No vitamin D in a zebra.
It's interesting. I wonder if it's white or dark meat. Nice. Okay. I asked you, Corrupt FM asked you what Beyonce and Jay-Z named their twins.
They asked if we knew what they named their twins, and my answer remained no.
So I put that down. No, brackets D. David for the Tinsel Sisters.
Yeah.
And then I know the names as well. It's Rumi.
Ruby.
Rumi.
Rumi. Rumi.
No.
Rumi, what, like a hatchback?
No. That's not the name of the twins. Rumi and Sakata.
What are you saying, Catherine?
Catherine definitely
Sir
knows.
Carter is right. But then I think the other baby is called Remy.
But I can tell you one thing, Catherine, and this is going to eat you up inside.
No.
Just because you pride yourself on knowing this shit, you don't.
Oh.
Roisin, David, you got that right. It was Rumi and Sakata, not whatever you put.
Well done.
Richard Noel, I presume...
I put one and two, and Richard put...
I put Jedward.
Jedward, he put...
Okay, so a point, no point, no point. Okay.
That's brutal.
After becoming the most watched YouTube video this year, I asked you what despacito actually means in English. What did you put?
Boom boom times.
Boom boom times.
I put car battery.
Yeah. I think despacito, car battery.
Or boom boom times. It's one of the two.
One of the two. Okay, I can tell you it is neither of the two. Okay, Catherine, Big Nasty.
Give him the Spanish, Big Nasty.
Hola, amigo, soy Big Nasty. But get it on a tear in the power of one. Crispacho means slowly.
Woo-hoo!
Why would you say that you in Spanish if I wanted the English?
The English version of it is slowly.
Yes.
Mo Farah-sign.
Not a Mo Farah-sign!
If you were ever in a sitcom, I think that would be your catchphrase.
Yeah. David Roisin, what did you put?
We put it might be calmly, and then, but the spelling at the speed you might despot.
Machine was trying to write then was at the speed you might deposit something. Desposito. Quite often, when learning a foreign language, you just sort of guess what it vaguely sounds like.
Good point, my mate. That's the wrong answer. It means slowly. You get
slowly.
The point.
Gracias, amigo. Gracias.
Shall we have a little listen?
Oh, please.
Despacito, let's have a listen. That's enough.
I've never
okay.
heard.
Okay, I ask you, did you know how Tim Westwood embarrassed himself on Snapchat? Richard, Noel, what did you put?
We just put he admitted he had it because...
Snapchat.
A man of his age...
shouldn't have Snapchat.
..could not be having Snapchat.
That almost deserves a point. I think a very good point well made.
Can
David
we have
Roisin?
A point? Because we haven't had one for about fucking 9 years.
David Roisin?
We didn't hear the question, so we just responded to the picture and wrote Leonard Nimoy's son.
I also do know the answer.
Catherine, Big Nasty, what was the answer? What did he do, Catherine?
Tim Westwood DM'd a lady.
Did what?
But
did
it
what?
Was direct message, but yeah. it was public. And he wrote, like, I'm gonna take you on a date and pay for you to get a new clutch and a hair and some heels, like just some really weird off-pieced accessories.
It's so gross.
Yeah.
So you may want to get your nails and you may want to get a wax.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then he said, don't go buying a house or a car or something.
Oh, and he shared his bank card That's with it. It as well. I appreciate you may want to wax. That was it. It was difficult to read. It's difficult to remember now. It's so good.
So he sent his card detail so that she can sort of smarten up in advance of meeting.
So he sent this picture, which is his credit card with all the details, and then he sent a message saying, baby, looking forward to taking you to dinner on Thursday. I appreciate you may want to get nails, hair and a wax, even some new shoes or a clutch bag. Use my card. It's black with private banking, so there's no limit, but don't be buying a new car, lol.
She should have bought a car and got it waxed.
Thank you.
Okay, so at the end of that round, the scores are Richard and Noel have 4 points, David and Roisin have 8, Big Nasty and Catherine have 10 points in the lead. We've got to take a quick break now, so you've got a choice. You can either come back and join us after, or you can play Pictionary with your family. Yeah, thought so. See you in a minute. To the Big Fat Quiz. Our next round is all about film and TV in 2017. In July, the BBC announced they'd cast Jodie Whittaker as the first ever female Doctor Who. Some fans couldn't get on board with a female Doctor Who. Presumably thinking Daleks, sure, Cybermen, of course, Weeping Angels, all make sense, but a female Doctor is just not believable. Despite its controversial move to Channel 4, Bake Off remains a fan favourite. It's got great hosts, brilliant contestants, and the icing on the cake is literally the sugary stuff they put on the top of the cakes. OK, first up, let's remind ourselves of some of this year's TV highlights.
On your marks, get set, bake!
Boy drops and girl drops, you see. Why do they leap?
Only interested in one thing here and one thing only, and that's bent cobbles.
You look like a tentative Nazi.
Sorry, what's glow?
Gorgeous ladies of wrestling.
I just found my favorite show. My children are schizophrenic. It is raging.
Wow.
Here's some TV and film questions for you. Okay. You eating a biscuit?
Biscuit?
No.
You're probably going to be saying, I'm eating a biscuit next.
There better not be CCTV footage of this.
We haven't got any snacks.
We've got raisins if you want.
Thank you, Richard.
Anyone want raisins?
Well, it's fun doing shows with
you. Oh, well, after that one.
In the orange and black.
Only.
You
want to
get
that?
Okay. First up, I want to know why a BBC News interview with Professor Robert Kelly became an internet sensation in March.
It won't get mad because it's 2 years old and it really matters.
Emily
OK. Have a look at these three famous faces. We've got Meryl Streep, The Rock and Matt Damon. What has flabbergasted all of them? Why do they look so surprised? What's going on there? Next up, it's star of Brawl in Cell Block 99, Vince Vaughn.
Hi, Jimmy. After a hard day's filming, I love nothing more than to kick back and watch a cookery show. But like many viewers on Twitter, I was very surprised by Mary Berry's bolognese recipe on her new show, Mary Berry Every Day. What ingredients did she add to this classic sauce?
Okay, so Vince wants to know what Mary Berry added to her bolognese sauce that shocked viewers. Okay, you all got something? All right. In October, reality show Love Island won Best TV Show at the Radio 1 Teen Awards. But what happened at the ceremony that eclipsed Love Island's win?
Oh, it was so good.
What is this? What is this image you're showing?
That's, I think that's the...
this is a foam party.
No, that's the... I think that's the Crystal Maze crew party. Were you not at it?
I was barely at the filming.
What is that, Janine?
That's Love Island. Yeah, that's the show Love Island.
Love Island is just an elaborate study about the effectiveness of the morning after pill.
They won a competition for the best television programme.
Yes.
Against the other television programmes. Like, you know, Blue Planet and Faulty Towers.
Well, I mean they won the best reality show.
Ah,
I suppose,
right. Best shit programme.
Fair enough. Jimmy, you've lost control of the quiz.
Thank you, Wizard Podium. OK. Take a look at these two clowns who appeared on This Morning in September. All I want to know is, why are those clowns upset?
Jimmy?
Yeah?
Just for consideration.
Yeah?
Would you ever do the show with an owl, like, on your shoulder?
With an owl? Like, if there was an owl
there? Don't rule it out immediately. You haven't really considered it.
I met the owl, the Harry Potter owl. Her name is Olympia, and she is an absolute legend. Really well-trained. I bet we could get her. But we can hook it up with my owl connections from working at Hooters, and then we can get Olympia. And you know what she eats? Frozen mice?
When they eat the mice, are they still frozen?
Because no.
That would be
yeah. Very refreshing on a hot day.
Yeah. All right, you ready for answers?
Yes.
I got answers, OK. I asked you why a BBC News interview with South Korean expert Professor Robert Kelly went viral back in March. What did you think? Roisin, David.
We said his kids come in the room.
OK. All right, what about Richard? No?
He's a Terminator.
He was a Terminator. The professor and expert on South Korea, you think he's a Terminator?
Do you know he's not a Terminator?
OK, Catherine, what's your answer to this?
Richard Kelly's kids ran in and his wife chased them and it wrecked the interview, or did it? Or was it the most fabulous North Korean interview?
I think it made an interview about South Korea a little more punchy. Let's have a look.
The question is, how do democracies respond to those scandals?
And what will it mean for the wider region? I think one of your children's just walked in. I mean, shifting sands in the region. Do you think relations with the North may change?
I would be surprised if they do. Pardon me.
The region.
My apologies. North Korea. South Korea's policy choices on North Korea have been severely.
It's so good. I mean, do you know what I love about that? It just keeps on giving. The first kid walking in like that, it's already that's enough to go viral. The second kid that can't even walk and walks in, that's remarkable. Just whoa, I'm on a weird floating device. And then the mum coming in. My favourite bit is at the end where she goes, I better crouch down and get the door. I don't think anyone's noticed.
This really is the perfect video, the best thing I've ever seen.
OK, so points, and because he doesn't melt into molten metal and then come back, not a Terminator,
Five
no points.
Points.
5 points? Okay. No points,
Ten
you
points.
Weird wizard.
10 points!
OK, I showed you three shocked celebrity faces. What I want to know is, what caused their reactions? What did you put?
We put they gave the Oscar to the wrong film and then didn't.
Team Payne, what have you got?
They were constipated at the Oscars when they found out that they got given the wrong award, La La Land.
Is that Meryl Streep? She's in all of those photos, getting smaller and smaller.
OK, what did you put, Richard? No?
Oh, is it because...
We put that they because had they... found out they were in a new title sequence for Dallas.
So points, no points. Next, Vince Vaughan wanted to know what Mary Berry had added to her bolognese sauce.
Human shit.
Sorry, that's your... Human shit is your joke answer. Your genuine answer is...
Viagra.
No, that's not true. We also did write down human shit.
Yeah. Viagra, human shit. Up to you. Oh, that's Jay-Z's kids. Viagra and human shit.
Big Nasty, Catherine.
This is Big Nasty's favorite show. He watches it, he knows the answer.
So she put some cream and wine in that thing.
Okay, what did you put, Roisin?
We put down cream, so we got it right, and Dolmio.
Well, cream and wine is the correct answer, so I'm going to give the points to Big Nasty and Catherine.
I think she's more of a cake expert. Yeah, that might be the thing. She's tried to make bolognese more like a cake. She probably pokes it and goes to the consistency of that sponge. It's terrible. I love a cake, but you can't turn spaghetti bolognese into a cake.
You could do the sauce, then a layer of the pasta, then a layer of the sauce, then a layer of the pasta.
You just designed a lasagna. You just invented lasagna. I asked you what happened at the Radio 1 Teen Awards that eclipsed Love Island's win. What did you all think?
The Sun gave everyone a blowjob.
Is it one of those, like a coupon, you cut it out and take it to your news agent?
Big Nasty, Catherine, what did you get?
Oh, it was incredible. So it was Love Island won Best Reality TV Show, and they'd created this mechanism where the winners came from under the stage on this hydraulic machine.
Like a trap door, yeah.
And as it was bringing them up, Gemma Collins, presenting the award, didn't know. So she was stood there just like, and the winner is Love Island. And then the hole opened, and she just went like,
David, Roisin, you got this as well?
Yes, we've got this.
Let's have a look at this lovely moment.
Love Island! Whoa. Did she ever get out of the hole?
OK. I asked you why two clowns were so upset on This Morning. What did you put?
It was when he broke down on TV, innit? About that horror film.
It.
Yeah.
That's the right answer.
Was it?
Yeah, it was not. Well, it was sort of slightly
bro,
selfish.
Give me the thing. What are you standing on with you, bro? Sweet, you love me, Jimmy. Mo Farah sign.
Can't believe he's got a catchphrase. He's been on telly 2 minutes. Okay, all right. So what did you put, Roisin, David?
We said, because it is making clowns seem creepy, except they were always creepy.
I mean, that's correct. Big Nasty and Catherine, you got
because
that.
Because it, and by the way, it, I meant, I it. Read it out wrong. I meant the film It. I should have put some inverted commas.
Richard, no?
Self-pity. And also that they lost money on poor investments.
Well, let's take a look. Let's take a look.
What do you think of because it was the original, I think it was 1986, the book, which is usually cited as the start of people's fear of clowns.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Slightly scared now.
Yeah, certainly in the mid-80s, the term when the coulrophobia or the fear of masks turned up was in the mid-80s.
Yeah.
So whether the two are linked together.
Tell me about this particular clown.
He's not a clown.
Pennywise.
It's not a clown.
They're the least funny clowns I've ever seen. They are like anti-comedy. Jesus Christ.
How dare you? I'm anti-comedy.
In fairness, they say that this clown is a little bit scary, Pennywise.
He's all right.
I'm not
that's true. OK, points, points, no points. Now it's time for a special bonus round. I'm going to show you three film posters from this year, which have all been subtly improved. All you have to do is tell me what the film is. Here's the first one. Write down your answer. Point for each.
Yeah.
All right, second one. Let's have a look.
How dare you?
All right, next one.
That's how I see myself.
OK, all right. So let's have a look, see what you put. First one, Yellow Lady. Now, remember, that's quite a big hit, wasn't it? Yellow Lady. There was another name for it. What was it called, Catherine?
That's Beauty and the Beast.
Oh. OK, and Richard, I know you got that as well. Let's have a look. If anything, better with me, but fine, OK.
No difference.
Next one, what have you got, Big Nasty?
Well, we've got Carlaland.
Carlaland.
Yeah, La La Land.
Excellent bit of punning. Richard, no. La La Land. David, Roisin.
La La Land featuring Yellow Lady. It was the sequel to Yellow Lady, because the character of Yellow Lady really took off, so they thought, we've got to find something else for it.
All right, and the third one? OK, so you put...
Incredible Hulk and the Roman.
would have been a better title for it, OK.
Yeah,
what did you put?
Avengers.
You thought the Avengers?
Oh, is it? Yeah. Our Avengers.
Which didn't come out this year. And which did not?
We put the Avengers, but now, looking at it, it's bloody Thor Ragnarok, and I feel like...
Thor Ragnarok is the right answer, but you didn't get it. So at the end of that round, the scores are David and Roisin have 13, Big Nasty and Catherine have 17, yeah. Richard and Noel, lucky to have 6. To focus on the true meaning of Christmas, consumerism. We'll be back right after these ads. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. Our next round is all about the internet in 2017. Where would we be without the internet? Well, we'll find out next year when Russian cyber terrorists freeze our accounts. In February, Disney cut ties with the world's highest paid YouTube star, PewDiePie. I love PewDiePie. He's my go-to guy whenever I want to watch someone I've never heard of talk about something I don't care about. OK, ready for some more Big Fat Questions? These are all about the internet this year. First one, can you remember why an evening at home for the Fleming family in County Kerry, Ireland, went viral back in September?
Jimmy, help us. Look at us. We've got nothing.
Jimmy,
we've got 6 points.
Jimmy, we've got so few points.
We are behind the audience right now.
They filmed the thing and it went viral.
Oh. That's everything on YouTube.
Let's just write that. They filmed the thing and it went viral.
OK, Jimmy next said. Up, Nadia Hussein has a question for you. Nadia.
Hi, Jimmy. Like everyone, I love sharing pictures of food on social media. But this year, 16-year-old Carter Wilkerson set a world record when in April he tweeted about his favourite food, becoming the most retweeted message ever. Can you remember what it was about?
So, most retweeted message ever, what was it about? OK. During the general election campaign, Conservative MP for East Yorkshire, Greg Knight, became an unexpected internet hit. He posted a campaign video that went viral. Can you remember why that campaign video was so remarkable?
Who is it, Greg Knight?
It's Greg Knight. We've got a picture of him there. I'm pretty sure that's him, not a waxwork of him.
He looks like Peep Show without a beard.
I'm going to have to defend my tinsel sister here.
I'm struggling to take that as a compliment.
Mo Farris sign.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Jimmy.
I forget what that is even meant to be.
Go on, Jim. You know you want to. Put it up there, Jim.
Let's only answer
Rushy,
in
none of this. Oh. No. More questions.
Do you think, though, because Big Ben says bong, right? When they bring it back, should they get it to say Ben? Ben.
Yeah, it just sounds like you've lost an animal you no longer care about.
Ben.
Oh.
Ben. Probably dead now. Ben. It's been 2 weeks. Ben.
Hey, Poncho, tell him he's lost control of the show.
You've lost control of the quiz, Bon.
Did you just call Noel Poncho?
Poncho.
I responded.
I don't know names. I'm sorry, I don't know names. Let's keep it short.
OK, Donald Trump's presidency got off to a rocky start this year and he continued to put in the hours on Twitter. Can you complete this tweet he sent on the 31st of May? Despite the constant negative press, complete the tweet. Couldn't be easier. OK. Finally for this round, why did this picture of the then 2-year-old Isla Walton from Exeter take the internet by storm back in March?
That is him. That's Ed Sheeran.
If you write that down, you might get a fucking point.
But Ed Sheeran. I've been on Buzzcocks with him. It's definitely him.
OK, everyone finished? You all got something? Let's have some answers. So I asked you why the Fleming family from County Kerry went viral earlier this year. What did you think?
They filmed a thing and it went viral.
They did what, sorry?
They filmed a thing and it went viral. In brackets, Jimmy said. Must be right.
Big Nasty, Catherine.
OK, so the answer is,
I've put up Cork because my family is from Cork. So up Cork is an important part of my answer.
Okay.
And because of my Irish roots, I know that it was a bad attack.
Okay, what did you put? David Rushing?
Never mind how bad it was. What attacked them?
A bad bat.
It was a bat,
one of his relatives, the vampire's relatives.
Yeah. Bong,
bong, bong.
Bell Saracine.
We're here to stay calm, man.
Come on, Jimmy, sit down.
All right, so what did you get, David?
They were trying to catch a bat, and crucially, it was video. There may be many, many far more hilarious bat-catching antics that are lost to posterity.
Let's treat ourselves to a little look at this family trying to catch a bat.
Catch him! Catch him, Derry! Derry, catch him! There's a bat! Get a bat!
Look at the bat!
Get a bat out of the house! Mum, will you get out? Derry, will you catch him? Catch him, Derry. Bigger towel, that's it. Get him, quick. Get him. Oh, fuck it! God, Derry! Oh! You're doing a great job, Derry. Oh, that's it. Stand up, Derry. Oh! Did you get him? No, he's there. He's making a mockery out of you, boy. You get down off this. Take off them shot. The dog's pissing! Dad, the dog's after peeing!
Okay, so Nadia Hussein wanted to know what Carter Wilkerson tweeted to become the most retweeted message ever. What have you got?
I thought maybe it was feed him green, keep him keen.
No.
But my associate disagrees.
Above that, you've written
nuggets, bruh.
Yeah. Okay.
We put nuggets, brackets, of edible matter.
Good, okay, and...
I can't remember what the question is, but I put a moose anus.
Which, you know, in some ways could be a nugget.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you, he asked fast food chain Wendy's for a year's supply of chicken nuggets in exchange for 18 million retweets. And there he is, he couldn't be happier.
And that's Beyoncé's one of the twins?
OK, I asked you why Tory MP Greg Knight became a hit during the general election. Why did Greg Knight become such a hit during the election?
Because he had a song that lasted 3 weeks.
OK, what did you put, Big Nasty?
We thought about things that went viral and we didn't know, so we thought maybe he got a cat involved or he did a dance.
OK, Richard, Noel?
We put he buried an abstract concept.
Well, I can tell you, you got it absolutely right with the shit song. Should we treat ourselves? I mean, it's quite extraordinary. OK.
Hello, my name's Greg Knight. I'm the Conservative candidate for East Yorkshire. There's a general election on the 8th of June, and I hope, if you live in East Yorkshire, that you'll vote for me.
You'll get accountability with Conservative delivery. Make sure this time you get it right. Vote for Greg Knight.
I like the beat, though.
It's
that old school, like Miami Vice things.
You like the beat?
Song? Yeah.
All right, well, hang on, we've got the lyrics. Do you want to try and...
Give it vibes.
Try and give it vibes, because I think there's a lack of vibes on that. Let's have that again.
All right, let's do it. Run the rhythm. DJ, hit me now. BVL bits the first sleep. It's
you right. Get accountability. Servitude delivery. Make sure you get it right.
Because
you're totally shite.
Yeah.
Nice. Nice. I can see how he might listen to that and go, the you're totally shite ending to the song. Not quite what he was looking for. He won as well. Who was running against him?
But looking at that video, the level of party funding in this country hasn't quite reached American levels, has it?
Someone decided that he should start outside the room.
Yeah.
He started, he went, no, get me walking in. I've been out and about.
Also, I like that they said, well, during the song, it's probably best not to focus on your face anymore.
Let's go to a poster stuck up with sellotape on the outside. Like, you've never stuck up a poster on a wall
before. It would have been better if he, at the beginning, emerged from a cupboard. have been really. That would have. Yes. It would, there's mystery there. Yes. There's a sort of narrative. Why was he in the cupboard?
Okay. I asked you to complete the tweet from Donald Trump. Despite the constant negative press, what did you put?
I still put my penis up my bum.
What did you put, Big Nasty?
I blocked him on Twitter. I told him to suck his mum, so.
Well, that's probably what set him off.
Come on.
You blocked him?
Yes.
I love that.
I love that.
Can you just stop hounding me, Donald?
Okay, what have you written there, Catherine?
We guess, despite the constant negative press, my followers are dumb and disenfranchised enough to trust me. We thought maybe he got with
you
it.
You thought he got one true tweet during the year?
Because they do, they just doesn't matter what he tweets, they will always love him.
What did you put?
Well, it was a gibberish word, but we weren't sure how to spell it, so we've had a few goes.
Confetti. Which, because it has no meaning, probably is the only thing that isn't a lie.
Coffeefe. It was despite the constant negative press, coffeefe.
Jimmy, we put that bottom left.
we got it right. Coffeefe.
Coffeefe.
Have you got that?
We did.
Hang on, they're claiming they got that. Where is it?
Come off it. Look at the screen.
Oh, yeah, all right.
To the far left of penis. The title of my autobiography.
So, points, no points. Yeah. Lastly, I asked you, why did Isla Walton take the internet by storm? What do you put? You all got this?
Because she's Ed Sheeran.
She looks like Ed Sheeran. Let's have a look, side by side.
It's so cute.
I'm sure she's going to be a very pretty young girl, but she looks amazing like Ed Sheeran in that. All right, it's now time to welcome a special guest. It's Liam Charles from the Great British Bake Off.
Just take one of these.
Mince pies and mulled wine. I mean, we're not messing around. This is Christmas.
Yay. My daughter cried when you left, and then we couldn't watch it anymore.
Seriously?
Yeah. I don't eat that mince. No.
Who thought that Liam should have won?
Yeah.
Thank you, my love. Do you want David?
Yes, Miss Pies.
Thank you very much. No, thanks, lovely. Thank you very much, though.
Thanks.
I will have a mince pie. I've changed my mind.
Yeah. You leave the tray over there with them. That'll be fine. Come on, Liam. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Now, tell us, you're still... obviously, you did brilliantly on Bake Off.
Thank you.
You're still at university, right?
Yeah, third year.
Third year at university and you're on Bake Off. What did everyone else at university make of it?
Everyone was really, like, positive about the whole thing. It was a bit weird going back the first day. Because, like, there were so many people double-taking all the time. I was like, yeah, it is me.
Yeah, I'm a pretty big deal. Noel, what was your favourite cake?
Liam did quite a lot of flavours that I liked. He did lots of caramel flavours, lots of butterscotch, lots of banana. So I always liked his stuff.
Liam made a cool, like, pie that had mango in it and all kinds of good things.
That's curry goat.
Curry goat.
You
did
a curry goat, Maggie.
Bro, I made curry goat pie.
Curry goat cake. Yes.
No, it was like a hand-raised pie.
Yeah, and he left the hooves in.
And the horns and all sorts.
Come on, bad man thing, you know.
Look at Jimmy, he doesn't know what's happening. He's gluten-free.
I don't think there's any gluten in a goat.
Okay, you've got a question for us, Liam. What's your question?
I do have a question.
Oh, it's in your bag, all right, cool.
Go. So, which craze of the year was banned from schools in 2017?
Which craze?
Yeah.
I think I know.
You think you know? Okay, so a craze was banned from schools.
David, did you ever wonder that...
Don't call him David, call him Peep Show.
Sorry, the what? Look, did you ever think that undoing the second button from the top would be a little bit racy?
Well, like, this is... Yeah, absolutely. This is respectability, sex appeal.
Thank you.
Okay, so have you all got answers?
I think I know, because my daughter goes to school and her teacher, Jack, banned dabbing because it, like, bothered him or something.
Banned what?
Dabbing.
Dabbing, you know, when they go like this?
I thought dabbing was sort of like, you know, dab something.
No, so...
Dab, not like that. That's not dabbing.
Can we go on some dabbing?
That's it.
Richard, Noel, what have you got?
Fidget spinners.
Oh!
Okay, David, Roisin, you got?
We put fidget spinners.
Okay, well, tell them.
It's actually fidget spinners.
Yay!
And he's brought you fidget spinners.
Yay!
The nicest man in the world. Liam Charles, everyone. Nicest man in the world. Have you used these before?
Yeah.
Spin, wada, spin.
Now, this is the rest of the show, isn't it?
Oh.
Look.
You good?
My nephew's a pro. He does this thing, right, where he's like, uncle, look what I can do. And he goes, ah. He puts it on his head and he spins it.
Let go with one finger.
Oh, right, OK. Hey.
Go on, Jimmy. Oh. Ah, it really gets you in the eye, though. OK, let's take a look and see what that's done to the scores. OK, so Richard and Noel have 9 points.
9 points.
David and Roisin have 19. Big Nasty and Catherine are one ahead with 20. We're going to take a quick break now to play with our fidget spinners. But, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Liam Charles! Can't believe I like it. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. This next round is all about the sport of 2017. Who can forget the sporting events of this year? Is exactly what we're about to find out. Usain Bolt retired in 2017. He's won 8 Olympic gold medals and 11 World Championship golds. But he ended his career in August with a bronze, like a loser. OK, time for some more Big Fat Questions all about sport this year. OK, woo! In March, Madeira Airport was renamed in honour of Cristiano Ronaldo. But what aspect of the renaming ceremony caught everyone's attention, with some describing it as a monstrosity? Renamed Aeroporto Cristiano Ronaldo, which is a great name for an airport. OK. MMA fighter Conor McGregor's boxing match against Floyd Mayweather took place in Vegas. Why did McGregor's choice of outfit raise eyebrows at the pre-fight press conference?
Because he's not...
Oh, I know.
Okay.
We know!
OK, next up, over to Claire Balding.
Hi, Jimmy. An athlete's diet is very important, but it's quite unusual to take a snack break mid-competition. But in February this year, a quick bite resulted in a footballer from Sutton United receiving a £375 fine and a 2-month ban from the FA. Can your teams tell me what happened?
So why was that football player fined and banned?
I'm allowed to answer it now.
No, you can just write it down.
Oh.
Team pain, we want to know. Is
how could you not have got the hang of this by now?
You haven't said the Tinsel Sisters for a while.
Tinsel Sisters? You are the Tinsel Sisters.
Yeah. Thank you.
It's implied you are the Tinsel Sisters. Team Payne and Cakes in a Maze.
Aren't we sharks with no knees or something?
No. You're not sharks with no knees.
Jimmy.
We're not Jimmy.
Do you want a team name?
Yeah, I'd love to have a team name.
What do you want to call yourself?
No Seat Jimmy.
OK, everyone, let's get on with the quiz. In November of this year, Grand Slam queen Serena Williams got married. Congratulations to her. She wore an Alexander McQueen gown and looked fabulous, but what was unusual about her shoes?
Yeah, but what's your team name? I'm finding it hard to connect with you because we're all teams and you're just Jimmy.
That's not the reason you're finding it hard to connect.
Maybe the puppet from Goosebumps?
Well, it should sound a bit more plural rather than just an attack on yourself.
Yeah, leave that to us, Jimmy.
Yeah.
How about you can be, like, the patriarchy?
Yeah. How dare you?
Yeah, but that's exactly. A collective.
Shh, no, men talking, please. Yeah. Patriarchy. Uh-huh. OK. This year, Olympic winner Michael Phelps lost a high-profile race. Do you remember who his unusual opponent was?
Oh. Who was it? Yeah.
OK, are you ready for some answers? So
I was born ready.
All right, first up, I asked, what caught everyone's attention at the renaming of Madeira Airport? What did you all have?
They made a statue of Ronaldo's head, but it wasn't Ronaldo's head, it was Greg Davies' head.
OK, and what did you put, Big Nasty, Catherine?
Well, you said it was monstrous, and I don't know who that is, and I guessed maybe one of his balls has filled with fluid.
Not even wrong, I'm going to say no.
You don't know?
No.
That one of his balls is not filled with fluid? Because
I know a lot about his balls. They're perfect, I'm sure.
Yeah, that'd be so...
There's definitely fluid within one of the balls. It's just a question of volume.
I have seen a ball that...
OK, Richard, Noel, what did you get?
Statue, in brackets, gold.
OK, let's take a look. Well, I mean, you're absolutely right. They did make a statue of Cristiano Ronaldo, and it did look a bit like Greg Davis. the funny thing about that is, presumably, the day before that, the presentation, that the sculptor was going, what do you think? And someone must have gone, yeah, no, it's good.
Absolutely.
That's fine. I just like him.
I think the mistake with that bust is making of him smiling. You don't usually do statues of people doing a big grin. I think that's probably why. You know, when you go to Trafalgar Square, all those generals, they're not going... So I think probably with a statue, go for the solemn-faced look.
I've never seen teeth in a...
Yeah.
Normally, you don't really see their teeth.
Winston Churchill in Parliament Square, he's not going...
I asked you what was unusual about Conor McGregor's outfit. What did you think? Richard Noel might have got one.
Yes, thank you for
really?
That passive-aggressive comment. we didn't stipulate the actual offence, but it contains a swear. Yeah.
OK, it contains a swear, we'll do. Big Nasty?
Yeah, it had F-U all down the sides and that.
And also, it was super tiny.
David, Roisin, did you get this?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, let's have a look. You're absolutely right. He wore a suit with a swear.
With fuck you on it.
Sewed into it, which...
That's really cool, and I've seen a lot of tailors who do that. What would you have your tailor emblazon in there if you could choose a saying?
I would, all the way, everyone would say tax deductible. Okay, Claire Balding said, why did a Sutton United footballer receive a 2-month ban and a £375 fine? What did you get?
A man? What's he called?
The man and the thing that you were saying.
All of that stuff.
The man and the thing that I was saying, yeah, so far so good.
Okay, yeah. He ate a pie and put a bet on when he was going to eat, whether he would eat... I've had so much fucking sugar. He had, David, finish.
Yes. The guy in the football match ate a pie, having previously put a bet on that he'd eat a pie, and then won the bet because he did eat the pie, but that was against the rules, so he got fined.
Football fans are obsessed with who's eating the pie.
And then he resigned. He resigned as the goalie, was he?
He was the goalie.
That's easier to eat a pie.
That is the right answer. And can I just say, the worst delivered right answer we've ever had. It's entirely right, though.
Give it time.
What did you get, Big Nasty, Catherine? Yeah.
We knew it. He broke the rules, didn't he, by eating the pie.
OK, Richard, Noel?
Yeah. I ate a pie.
Yeah.
There was odds of 8-1 on him eating during the match, so he ate a pie. OK, I wanted to know what was unusual about Serena Williams' shoes when she got married?
They were tennis rackets.
You are so close.
And it also had to draw on a snail saying that, so if it's not the right answer, we didn't say it.
Blame the snail.
Blame the snail.
David, Roisin?
She had three of them. She was wearing three shoes.
That's my favourite thing anyone said all night.
Three.
She's wearing three shoes.
Where's the third shoe?
On her other leg.
What? So
50 points.
Okay, Big Nasty, Catherine, what did you get?
She had diamond tennis shoes. She put some of these on her traps.
Yeah, that is the right answer. Let's
is
take
it?
A look.
Yeah.
Those are her
She's
Nike
so
Cortez
right.
trainers, bejeweled with real crystals.
And look what I'm doing with my spinner, bro.
I know.
Stop. Stop.
To be fair, since you gave us fidget spinners, you ain't heard a peep out of me in there.
They really do work.
I would say there's nothing really unusual. I mean, she's a tennis player. And on her wedding, she wore sort of especially posh tennis shoes. That's the answer to the question, what was unusual, is there was nothing unusual. It's just, it's just what you'd have expected. It's so unoriginal as to be not worth mentioning.
Next, I wanted to know who Olympic swimmer Michael Phelps lost a race to this year.
Seated shark.
Seated shark.
Seated shark. You're so happy with seated shark.
Or a human arm. No. That arm coming in from the right.
I will give you that, seated shark.
Thank you.
You've written what, Catherine?
He tried to race Jaws.
He tried to race Jaws? Yeah, OK, I'll give you that. And did you get this?
Yeah, we said a CGI non-member of Boyzone, brackets, callback. Thank you.
Well, let's take a look, and this goes to show the Discovery Channel are out of ideas.
Swimmers, take your mark.
Thank you. I don't get that. They added the shark in post-production, right? And then went, yeah, it turns out you lost.
Yeah. A human is never going to beat a giant fish at swimming. He might as well get a high jumper to take on a pigeon. Who can jump higher, the man or the pigeon? Oh, the man's doing quite well. Oh, the pigeon's doing quite well. Oh, the pigeon. Oh, the pigeon's still going. Oh, the pigeon's just completely fucked off now, and the man has landed.
What I love about that race is people were really upset that it was a CGI shark.
Well, like, they didn't put him in with a real one.
Yeah, they were really upset. They tweeted, it should have been a real shark. We tuned in for a real shark.
Could have eaten him.
Well, yeah, they would have.
It probably wouldn't have eaten him because, as people are at pains to say, sharks don't eat many people compared to, say, hippos, who don't
eat them. Hippos eat people.
Yeah, they don't eat them. They're vegetarians, but they kill them. Hippos kill loads of people.
No way.
They do, yeah.
Yeah, they do, yeah. Yeah.
This one's got to talk about the tabloids and the media because the media's got the sharks on it. Fucking hippos, the real gangbanger. You know what I mean?
Also, marbles. Yeah, they're fucking mental for marbles.
Yeah. To be fair, though, Jimmy, they are quite hungry.
Yeah, that's a good point. OK, let's see how you're all doing after that. So, Richard and Noel, you've got a 13, which is not bad for you, considering David and Roisin have 23, very Big funny. Nasty and Catherine have 24, just in the lead.
I'm taking this.
Join us after the break, because, to be honest, I'm not comfortable being left alone with these people. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of the Year. Our next round is all about people. Considering there are 7.6 billion people on the planet, it's absolutely incredible that Donald Trump is the man Vladimir Putin picked to be president. In July, Vince Cable became leader of the Lib Dems. Yeah, that's right, Vince Cable and the Lib Dems both still exist. O.J. Simpson was released on parole this year. What's next for O.J.? Well, he's a charismatic American celebrity with a short temper and a history of misogyny. Maybe he'll run for president. OK, time for some more big fat questions. In November, Man of the Year Stormzy found himself in a spot of bother at the MTV VMAs. He asked his Snapchat followers for help. What was his predicament? David Mitchell knows. Of course he does. OK, for our next question, it's over to one of the world's finest actors, Charles Dance, who's reading an extract from an autobiography released in 2017. All I want to know is, who is the mystery author?
Chapter 4, February 2016. Gary was being so affectionate and complimentary to me all night. He was whispering stuff in the club like, tonight we're not having sex, we're making love. I told him I didn't know what that meant, but it sounded amazing. He then said, we'll be kissing the whole time. It'll be slow, then fast. Sounded so sexy. We snuck off back to the shag pad for our very first lovemaking session. All I kept thinking was, I hope I've shaved my fanny. But Gary was a bit worse for wear. There wasn't anything sexy about that. The whole room was spinning. He puked all over the floor. What the hell? Gary's never sick and it stunk. If this is what making love is all about, then rule me out. I'm all right with a quick shag. Because of the smell in the shag pad, we went back to my bed in the girls' bedroom to sleep. I had a Brucey bonus because we woke up a few hours after we'd passed out and started to get frisky. Making love to Gary was like the first time I tried a cheeseburger. Sexy, sensual, and satisfying.
That was Charles Dance there. OK, so whose autobiography was he reading from?
So presumably whoever wrote that only tried a cheeseburger as an adult.
That's so sad. That's so sad.
Jeremy Corbyn had a very successful year, but can you remember what happened when he tried to high-five Shadow Foreign Secretary Emily Thornberry back in June?
What happened when he tried to high-five?
Yeah, what happened? OK, next up, over to Ed Balls.
Good evening, Jimmy. Shadow Chancellor, I love hearing about young entrepreneurs. So this year, I was thrilled to read about Nathan John Baptiste, a 15-year-old schoolboy who was reported to be turning over more than £20,000 before his school put a stop to it. Can your teams remember what his business was?
OK, what type of business did 15-year-old Nathan John Baptiste set up at school? Now it's time for a Say What You See. Simple, just say what you see. The answer to the question is just in what you're seeing, if you just say those things.
Mitchell.
Actually, don't say what you see, write down what you see. And it's a write down what you see question. Write down what you can see. Well done. Okay, you ready for some answers?
Are we?
Okay. Okay, so I asked you, in November, Man of the Year Stormzy found himself in a spot of bother at the MTV VMAs. What was the problem?
Gemma Collins fell on him.
That's a very good answer. Okay, what do you got?
Locked in the stalls. He was locked in the cubicles.
He was taking a dump and got trapped in the women's toilets.
Hang on. He must have gone in the women's toilets.
Yes, that
unless the dump propelled him into the women's toilets.
Well, he would have gone in the male's toilets, so there's a wee in the toilet seat and stuff.
David Roisin, did you get this?
We did. We've said Stormzy got stuck in the loo because he was too big for his boots.
Oh!
Come on!
Points all round on that one. OK, Charles Dance read an extract from a celebrity autobiography out this year. Whose was it? What do you think, Noel?
Richard? Roger Black.
Roger Black.
You thought it was Roger Black?
The hurdler. The hurdler. The Olympic hurdler, Roger Black.
We've lost the fucking will to live.
Roger Black. I thought Roger Black was one of the most handsome athletes of all time, wasn't he?
He can't write
a good
shit.
Reference. I have not Roger heard Black. Roger Black referenced in some time.
Nice. OK, it is not Roger Black. Big Nasty, what do you put for this?
Oh, it's Charlotte from Geordie Shore. He was getting mortal.
Oh!
She had a bit of a bounce on Gaz's cock.
That's nice. Very good.
David Roisin, what have you got?
We thought either Charlotte Crosby or Princess Anne.
You thought that might have been from Princess Anne?
I haven't read either of their autobiographies, so I couldn't be sure, but it seemed her tone of voice.
OK, let's go back to Charles Dance for the answer.
That was an extract from Brand New Me, the memoirs of Charlotte Crosby. Let's get mortal.
No. But very well done. OK. Thank you, Charles Dance. God love you. OK. Jeremy Corbyn had a very successful year. Can you remember what happened when he tried to high-five Shadow Secretary Emily Thornberry back in June?
He went into the future.
In a sense, he did. He literally did continue into the future.
Exactly.
I mean, in terms of the continuum,
yeah.
You cannot...
He didn't freeze in time.
Yeah. Yeah.
He went into
he
the
did
future.
Go into the future.
He didn't travel back in time. No, I mean, you're right, in a sense.
Exactly.
But not an actual
50
sense.
Points.
We're not...
50
no.
points.
Stop
hungry,
saying
hungry
50
Jimmy.
Points.
We're not right in a sense. We're just right.
What do you put, David?
He slapped her boob.
I say it, David writes it down.
Okay, Big Nasty?
Yeah, he kind of tried to caress that one still.
Let's take a look at the incident in question.
Do you think that's his first go at high-fiving?
I would say so.
What do you think they're thinking there? Yeah, there they are, the two of them. He's just slapped her boob by accident. They're both smiling like it didn't happen. What's going through their heads? Are they going, do you think no one noticed?
OK, Ed Balls asked you, what 15-year-old businessman Nathan John Baptiste set up at school? What was his business?
Sweatshop.
I thought you put sweet shop. I was going, yeah, cool.
No, that's not a business, is it?
£20,000 a year he was turning over in the sweet shop. They got it, sweets.
Sweatshop. Sorry, it's just a spelling error. We meant sweet shop.
Well, what did you put?
Haulage.
Nail bar.
Either haulage or nail bar.
You probably set up a nail bar in the toilets of your school.
Yes, you've got the dryers there.
You get the points, Big Nasty and Catherine. He set up a sweet shop. It was turning over £20,000 a year. He had 11 employees.
Wow.
I don't know why the school shut it down. It strikes me as excellent. OK, I asked you to say what you saw. What have you got? Richard, Noel?
Yes. Prince Philip announced retirement.
They got it!
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remarkable, isn't it? We like to get one right to prove we're not idiots.
Of course I got it.
Yeah. I'm going to be really honest. We had Prince Philip retirement, and then we were not sure about announced, but we definitely...
Oh, that's the pagan. I was on TV with that woman. That's Anne Sutton.
And that's Anne Woodard.
She is a pagan, yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
Why didn't you like Anne Whittacombe? Why?
Because, she's fake, bro. She tries to go on that. She knows about the streets and stuff. And she cares about poor people. She's in a warped life, bro.
I am no fan of Anne Whittacombe, but I would not say she's someone who pretends she either knows about the streets or cares about poor people. I would say she has not projected that image.
OK, so you got it absolutely right. David Mitchell, what did you...?
The same. Prince Philip announces retirement.
OK, so points, no points. We need the full phrase. OK, time now for a bonus round. This is the part of the show where I introduce a mystery guest. All you have to do is guess who they are and how they made the news this year. And you can only ask yes or no questions. Okay. Please welcome our mystery guest.
Yay!
Very good to see you. OK, so what questions? He made the news this year. Quite a big story.
Did you tweet something?
No.
Did you see something?
Yes.
And if you see something, say something.
Did you smell something?
Yes.
Did you witness something?
Yes.
Was it in London?
No.
Was it in Britain?
Yes.
Was it in England?
Yes.
Was it in the north of England?
No.
I've got to say, this is one of my favourite conversations ever. At current point, this is like tennis.
Wait, you didn't tweet it, you didn't share it. Did you share something?
Yes.
Was it criminal what you saw?
No.
Was it in an urban area of more than 200,000 inhabitants?
Yes.
Was it in Coventry?
Funny? No.
Was it in Bristol?
Did it involve...
Yes!
He smelt and saw and witnessed a funny thing that happened in Bristol.
Someone farted?
Yes.
What?
Someone in Bristol farted.
It's more than that, but this yes, you're on the news? Right lines. You're getting warmer with that.
Someone
yes.
in Bristol farting is not a massive story.
More than farted as a clue.
Shat.
Yes.
Sharted.
Is it an animal?
No.
Someone shat themselves in Bristol.
Again, I'm not thinking front page.
Shat themselves is the dream compared to what happened.
Oh! I okay. remember this.
Okay, write down what you think it might be. It involves someone shat, and it made the news. This guy was involved.
I can't remember exactly what happened.
Well, you've got to have a little think.
Wait, was that a festival?
It was not a festival.
I got it wrong, then.
Oh, no! Wait, I know!
We'll write it down! OK, let's have a look and see what they put.
Well, first, Big Nasty thought it was festival-related and public choice. We crossed that out, and then we put Bristol Poo Energy System.
OK, that's not anything. Richard, Noel, what have you got?
Did they poo and it went up like a lava lamp and never landed? That's not what we put.
No, something to do with Porter's Head.
That's the only thing.
Bristol. OK, all right, and what have you got? Roisin and David, please.
Someone got into some sort of trouble trying to retrieve their poo from between a window and its secondary double glazing.
In a bag.
That, my friend, is that the right answer?
Yes.
Yes, that is the right answer. Please explain who you are and why you made the news.
My name is Liam, and my date got stuck between two windows at my house earlier this year after she tried to throw her poo out of the window.
So you're on a date. You're on a date. You go back to your house. The lady excuses herself, goes to the bathroom, drops a deuce.
Yeah, it wouldn't flush. So she wrapped it up in toilet paper and she went to try and throw it out of my window. But unfortunately, my house had a weird sort of quirk of student housing design. There was two panes of glass and it got stuck in between.
So she essentially just put her poo on display?
Essentially, in a nice little case.
It's a nice display unit, like as you would get in a museum, maybe, for an artifact. So she put her poo on display, and then what happened?
Well, I thought we'd smash the window to get it out. She was a bit of an amateur gymnast, so she decided to climb in after it, and she got stuck.
Oh.
So who did you have to call?
The fire brigade came out.
OK, and were any of the firemen injured laughing that hard?
I think it was the call out of the week for them, yeah.
How did she tell you what had happened?
Yeah. She was very polite about it, actually. She came out and said, look, I'm really sorry, but this has happened and we're going to have to...
Yeah, it's the this that I'm interested in. We've skipped over the most interesting bit there. So she comes back and she says, my mummified feces are in the...
David and Roisin, you get the points. OK, let's see what that's done to the scores. I can tell you, Richard and Noel have 15 points, and David and Roisin and Big Nasty and Catherine both on 28. Oh. We're going to take a quick toilet break now. Ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for our special guest, Liam. Liam, thanks for coming on, mate. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz. The next round is all about the talking points and water cooler moments that define 2017. Let's remind ourselves what everyone was talking about this year. The new £10 note featuring Jane Austen was a triumph for feminists who'd long complained there were no women featured on banknotes, except, of course, the Queen, who's on all of them. Extreme weather caused worldwide devastation in 2017. Much of Texas was flooded. Whole Caribbean islands were left devastated. Vietnam had their strongest typhoon in a generation. And in Britain, a wheelie bin was blown over. Together, we'll rebuild. OK, final set of questions. All right. Eyewitnesses were delighted in April when they saw Tom Hardy spring into action on the streets of London. What was he doing?
Playing Zebedee.
Was he on Springs?
In September, two-year-old Emily Henson attended the Invictus Games and sat next to Prince Harry. Oh, what did she do on camera that made headlines around the world? She did something on camera that made headlines around the world.
You've got no
OK, for the next question, we're going over to the script.
Hello, Jimmy. This year, one tweet from everyone's favourite football pundit, Gary Lineker, it really caught our eye.
Yeah, that's right. Back in October, he tweeted, "The end is nigh."
But what strange phenomenon prompted him to tweet this?
I liked the bit earlier when there was a bat in their house.
What did they say, Jimmy?
Gary Lineker tweeted, "The end is nigh." Why did he tweet, "The end is nigh"? OK.
The end is nigh.
In November, Greggs the Baker's was forced to apologise after publicity shots for its Christmas advent calendar were criticised. Can you tell me what caused the offence?
Oh, yes.
Yes, David, of course, has an advent calendar from Greggs up in the house, I feel sure.
Do you know what? When I go to Greggs, yeah? First thing I do, I walk up to the woman and say, well, I go on, sister, you know what I'm saying, yeah? Don't want them dead sandwiches. I beg you, bust me if you love me. Go to the back and make me a special club. There's an extra £2 for the filling.
And she does it?
Of course.
Oh!
That's the most amazing brag ever. I go into Greggs and I get them to make me a special sandwich. I'm going to try it. It sounds amazing. I like it. OK. A US Navy pilot was grounded after residents in Washington witnessed the pilot doing something a Navy official described as wholly unacceptable and antithetical to Navy core values. So what was that US Navy pilot doing? So US Navy pilot, Top Gun style man, was doing something. What was it? I'll tell you what he was doing. He was taking my bloody breath away. It's a Top Gun reference, everyone.
That's right. There should be more refs to Berlin. Thank you.
OK, let's have a look at some answers, everyone. OK, I asked you what Tom Hardy did on the streets of London. What did you think?
Some fine acting.
You think people saw him acting?
And he also stopped a crime. Maybe some bad acting was happening near him.
So, stopped a crime. What did you get, Big Nasty?
Well, we stopped a robber.
Stopped a robber, OK.
That's a crime. Fine.
Yeah, OK. And Richard, Noel?
He said something about Taboo. I've no idea what he was talking about.
He was in a
about.
Show called Taboo. We just wrote that down. And then we just put he was.
in a show called Taboo.
I can't give you a point for that.
I was going to stick with he was.
OK, well, I'm going to give you points. Actually, Tom Hardy was spotted on the streets of London stopping a man who'd allegedly stolen a motorbike.
So we're right.
You're right. You get points for that. Well done. Point, no point. All right, next, I wanted to know what two-year-old Emily Henson was caught doing at the Invictus Games.
Stealing my man. She was flirting with my bae. She stole his popcorn. It was adorable. It was viral.
Did you get this? You got...
Ate his royal popcorn.
OK, and then... Stole his popcorn. Did you what?
Yeah.
Stole his popcorn and I drew a ghost, so that's an extra point.
Well, let's take a look. It is pretty adorable.
He initially, seriously, actually took the popcorn away from her. At the start, he genuinely did that, and then he tried to make up for it afterwards. If you look at that, he went...
He absolutely meant it.
He meant it.
But he is a prince. I mean, she's eating it for ages without him noticing. And when he does notice, he's like,
he went, back up. Back the fuck up.
Do you know who I am?
So the script wanted to know why Gary Lineker took to Twitter to claim the end was nigh. What did you put?
Yeah, he's given up on Walker's Chris to get rid of him, isn't it?
Nope.
The sky went, what is it? Weird sky.
Yes.
Caused by prawn cocktail dust.
Okay, Richard, Noel, what have you put?
What do you mean?
What have you got for this?
What for?
Sandstorm sky. We got it right, sandstorm sky.
Mind your own business.
Apologies, Noel, apologies. Okay, well, I can tell you, yes, Gary Lineker was worried that the world was ending because of the red sky. Let's have a look. Little sky over London.
I don't think Gary Lineker was really worried that the end is nigh. I think he was...
No.
I think there was, he was expressing levity, don't you? He was joking about it. So I think to say, stupid Gary Lineker thought the world was ending and now it hasn't, is a bit rough.
OK, Greg's The Bakers upset people with their advent calendar. Why?
Sausage roll.
Nativity scene.
Yeah. Replace Jesus.
They replaced Jesus with a...
Sausage roll.
Did you get this as well? Did you get this?
Yes.
Well, let's have a look and see. This is their nativity scene. No, I know, but if you look carefully, you will see that Jesus has been replaced by a sausage roll there. I can't see how that's... Who complained about that? I mean, if I was, you know, Jewish or Muslim, I might have a problem. But Christians, what have they got against a sausage roll?
Jesus was Jewish.
Yeah, but then the Christians complained about this.
Yeah, but he's a Jewish baby being played by a pork sausage.
Being played by? Is a snatch.
Give the sausage roll the dignity.
Open up the audition. What do you think, a steak bake should have got it?
If you're going to go meat in pastry, give it to the steak bake.
Have some respect. I must say, I'm not surprised that people complained.
No.
I think at the point where they thought, I tell you what would be really a bit of fun around Christmas, is if instead of Jesus, we had not just a sausage roll, but a sausage roll that someone's taken a bite out of.
It'd be fine if it was a mini sausage roll, but the scale is ludicrous.
Yeah. It's about the scale.
Like more of a canapé, yeah.
Well, you couldn't give... None of those little figures could have given birth to something that big.
OK, points all round on that one. And lastly for this round, I want to know why US Navy pilots got in trouble. What did they do?
Dick sky.
Dick sky?
We've written.
OK, Big Nasty, Catherine, what do you put?
Big Nasty knew the answer to this one.
What was it?
They were watching porn.
Yeah, you knew the wrong answer to this one.
Yeah, it's Dick Sky.
We all can know the wrong answer. It's Dick Sky. That's the right answer. Richard, no?
He had a shit in the cockpit and threw it out and he got caught between the glass.
Dick Sky's answer.
Let's take a look at what I can only describe as two pilots who have gone to Top Gun.
Dick Sky.
I think what you're looking at is Dick Sky.
Yeah.
It's a shame they didn't go back to do the little bit of sperm coming out of the air.
I guess, you know, budget cuts. OK, finally, it's time for the big question. Blue Planet 2 was the most viewed television show of 2017, who better to ask our final question than the cast of Blue Planet 2?
Oh, my God.
Hello, can we play with them? Let's play.
Hi. Penguin! Gang.
Freedom! Leg it! Holy fucking shit! Oh my fucking god!
Jimmy, what is going on?
All of it.
I mean, we let Penguin.
No, that's gas, though. I woke me up.
Did you genuinely think the polar bear was real?
Bro, for a hot second, I thought it was real and I was going to run.
For a hot second?
OK. Mr. Polar Bear, do you have a question?
Yes, I have some questions. I'd like the panel to tell me the most streamed artist in 2017, according to Spotify, and the most talked about person on Twitter in the UK in 2017, and the word of the year for 2017.
That seems pretty reasonable. Yeah, OK, cool. Cool, so three questions. So it's the most streamed artist according to Spotify, yeah?
Yes.
OK, and most talked about person in the UK according to Twitter?
That's correct.
I give you a clue, it's not Donald Trump. And the word or phrase of the year according to the Collins English Dictionary?
That's it.
Why the Collins Dictionary, not the Oxford English Dictionary?
Because I went to Cambridge.
Okay. All right. Go over and bother Noel. But don't spill the mulled wine on him, because...
Oh, it is cool.
He's pretty adorable, isn't he?
Jimmy, is the word of the year absolutely one word?
No, it's a phrase. It's a phrase.
Not that adorable, okay. Jimmy.
OK, so it's a point each, a 10-point bonus if you get all of them.
OK.
OK, so most streamed artist of the year, who did you think?
Taylor Swift.
Nah.
What did you think?
Or Ginger Bro, man. He smashed them.
Ed Sheeran.
Ed Sheeran, okay. And Richard Noel, you've gone with?
Ed Sheeran.
Ed Sheeran. Ed Sheeran is the right answer. Most streamed artist of the year.
My gosh. Okay.
All right, most talked about person in the UK. This is according to Twitter.
We went Jeremy Corbyn.
You went?
Yeah, Corbyn.
And you went?
Taylor Swift. We don't care.
Taylor Swift. We don't care. Okay. I can tell you the answer was Jeremy Corbyn. Most talked about person this year.
Again.
And the phrase or word of the year.
Dotard.
Dotard is not the right answer. You went with?
Bass.
BDL.
No, that is not the word of the year. And then you've gone for?
Fake news.
That was the word of the year.
Yes!
OK, let's see how you all did. I can tell you that in last place, predictably, Richard Iwadi, Noel Fielding, 19 points. I mean, well done. OK. With 33 points, Big Nasty and Catherine Ryan. But in first place, David Mitchell and Roisin Connolly with 35 points. You're the winners of the Big Fat Quiz of the year. 2018, that was your trophy. Thanks to all of you. A big thank you to our amazing panel, all our special guests, and thank you for watching. This has been the Big Fat Quiz of 2017. Good night.
Jimmy again, Friday from 9 o'clock on Channel 4 and 8 out of 10 Cats Countdown. Very Christmas special. Tomorrow from 9, Miranda on Channel 4. She's got David Tennant, Sam Smith and Prue Leith getting festive, not tweeting. Next tonight, a movie. When first shown, got 12.4 million viewers. We'll take something similar, 10 past 11 on Boxing Day night by Jahandor. Four weddings and a funeral.